And we're back. Alright. This is most likely the end. Let's what song is this? Well yeah, Kiri's like starting to feel like this, you know, it. Cancer pains. It's fucking Edward now.
You're right on time, as I'd expect, Kiryu-san. Welcome to Bleach Japan.
Gee, thanks. You know, I get this place is just another front for you, but still, little on the drab side, don't you think?
As long as it keeps people from sticking their nose where it doesn't belong. And why care? I'm done with Palakana. It was only a matter of time before that deal ran its course.
What?
Well, surely it was obvious. Nele Island, the disposal site. It was nothing but a cheap hole in the ground. The cave would naturally fill up at some point, which would mean, of course, pollution. It wouldn't work. Even with influence over the other countries involved, eventually the truth would come out. Frankly, I'm not sure what Bryce was thinking.
Yeah, me neither.
Whether the truth remained hidden or not was of little consequence in the grand scheme of things. It was destined to fail, and nothing could have changed that.
So what? You don't care? Then why? Why do any of this?
Much as it pains me, my own aspirations were never meant to be.
I thought it was just like...
Where's Sawashiro?
So, he's
but
right here.
Yakuza in as much pain as possible.
Sawashiro.
Ebina. You bastard.
What are you all so angry about? He's done the same to others countless times, has he not? Time and time again. An eye for an eye. A tooth for a tooth. I merely gave him what he rightly deserved. Of course, there's also those on Nele Island. They'll receive due punishment as well.
What's your problem? What do you have against the Yakuza?
Why ask what you already know? My mother, as you learned, was the Hikawa Patriarch's daughter, Yuriko Hikawa. And my father, just as you surmised, was Masumi Arakawa.
Yeah.
Regardless of whatever her father intended, my mother loved Arakawa with all her heart. On the other hand, she also knew that the man harbored deep feelings for another woman. Thus, she felt both joy and guilt. Indeed, she was engaged, but it was undeniably a mixed blessing. Perhaps if she bore their child, Arakawa couldn't ignore that. Surely his feelings would sway. Wishful thinking on her part.
And then you came into the picture.
Correct. But before the pregnancy came to light, Hikawa came under Arakawa's wrath. The family was destroyed. My mother was always frail, you see.
Aww.
Once she had me, the burden of raising a child alone was too much. A Yakuza's bonds are thicker than blood, we were told. Foolish words from foolish people. They never gave my mother a chance. When Hikawa died, the family went with him. I watched his men scatter like the rats they are. And yet...
Please don't hate them. Not your father. Not any of them.
Those were her last words. She was a fool too, it seems. Betrayed by the man she loved. Used by her own father. And tossed aside by those who called her family.
Yeah, that's pretty shit.
If not her, if she couldn't take revenge, then why on earth shouldn't I?
Because she doesn't want you to live your life dealing with revenge. She wanted you to have a life, not basically dedicated to revenge.
You wanted to make the Yakuza pay.
That's right.
Still, You said it yourself just now. Your aspirations were never meant to be.
How could they be? What would I have done? There's too many of you to count. Do I go around killing them one by one?
Believe me, I would if I were able.
Everything I've accomplished, why, it was simply the next best thing. A compromise, you might say. Honestly, it's been a long road. I first tried to eradicate your kind as a police officer, but you were one step ahead of me. Your great dissolution scattered you all to the wind. And that wasn't all. In the confusion that followed, Masumi Arakawa went and got himself killed.
Whoops.
That's when I realized vengeance would never be mine. That snake. I wanted to wring his neck myself. Masumi Arakawa. It's true he was loved among the Yakuza, oh yes. But all I see is the wretch who left my mother to die.
I'm so surprised.
Kasuga's reverence for him is a joke.
Kasuga isn't fighting him.
A sick mockery of my life.
Cause like I said, like, you know, it. I feel like the Yakuza series likes to have like poetry within their games, and I thought it was really poetic that in the end of Yakuza 7, you are fighting the young master Ryo Aoki. And both of you are, you're not sons, but you're technically, you're not brothers, but you're technically, like, brothers. Like, you're not family relationship, but, like, you two were switched at birth. But you all, not only just that, but also, they both saw Masumi Arakawa as their father, like, obvious, but in opposite ways, right? Like, Ryo Aoki saw Masumi Arakawa as his biological father, but, you know, also did his own thing, you know? And then, but was never actually biologically related. And then Ichiban thought he wasn't biologically related to Masumi Arakawa, but, like, idolized him. And was like, oh my god, I fucking love this guy. Like, he's such a great role model. But, you know, I actually was. So their fight kind of had, like, some poetry within it. So I felt that, like, having Ichiban fight Ebina would make the most sense because of how everything, like, you know, the fact that they are half-brothers, well, potentially half-brothers. And just, like, Ichiban's blind adoration for everything, and Ebina's straight hate for everything.
Kasuga's blind as they come. He's no different than those that Bryce fooled. Another Policana pig suckling at shit.
You son of a...
Oh my god. Why can't we beat him up now?
My dream to strike back at Arakawa had clearly been denied. It took a good deal of time to recover, but I knew I needed a new plan. So I set sights on the Yakuza, freed in the dissolution. All those years preying on those weaker than them, and now they wanted an honest life? Their dream would be as futile as mine. Then it dawned on me. So what if they're scattered? I'll just round them up. The Tojo and the Omi might have disbanded, but not the Seiryu clan. I baited new recruits however I could. A new Yakuza life? Fine. A cushy seat in society? But of course. Sure enough, they came marching in by the droves. Ants trickling in at the promise of sugar. If they only knew how stupid they looked. No later than that, I began thinking of a way to get rid of them all. When from Bryce comes a special business venture courtesy of our very own Eiji. By then, they'd already secured an LA island with Fujinomiya shipping as the means of transport. They just couldn't find the manpower.
Now, they were dealing with radioactive material, so that was only natural. But to me, well, it all sounded very convenient. Those stooges in the Serio clan, I knew just what to do with them. It was clear as day. I could make them suffer, subject them to far more than just unloading waste. Nele Island is effectively a giant black box. There'd be no running away, no refuge from their pain. Their cries would never escape the island. They'd be at my whim, wouldn't they? What a gift the island turned out to be. Like an antlion's trap, before long, it would drag them all to hell.
An antlion's trap?
AG proved more valuable than I thought. Nele Island wasn't all he brought me. I haven't told you, have I? Eiji's the one who figured out the truth behind Chairman Hoshino's murder.
Wait, what?
While at Bleach Japan, he learned much about Ryo Aoki. Or perhaps I should call him Masato Arakawa, yes? That hit on Hoshino was a ruse. Sawashiro was, for all intents and purposes, innocent in the affair. Amazing what a little leverage can do. He joined the Serio without hesitation.
Right. And then you had AG's web skills. Tatara Channel was your ace in the hole.
Indeed it was.
Well,
I suppose that's enough.
I feel like they didn't really tell me much new.
Wouldn't you say? Masumi Arakawa leaves two sons behind. One who worships the ground he walks on.
Yeah, this is what I'm saying.
And the other, who spits on his grave.
So why isn't Ichiban fighting this?
One works to rehabilitate the Yakuza, and the other, in all his hatred, sends them to their doom. We're mirror images, he and I.
You're not wrong there. But Ebina, there's one thing you might add to that. Care to guess what it is?
Go on.
You said the nuclear waste project was a compromise for taking revenge on the Yakuza, right? You said it was impossible to go after all of them. Ichiban's different. That moron. He seriously tried to give every one of them a normal life again. He sat there day after day, no matter how impossible it might have seemed.
Hot dog. I wish Ichiban could have heard all that.
Hot dog.
I'll knock your lights out.
Ebina. It's clear you're angry. I won't deny you that. I wouldn't have the right. It was a different time. But when I was chairman of the Tojo, I had a chance. I could have changed the Yakuza for the better.
Yeah, you made a big mistake.
I should have. But I didn't know such thing.
Him as chairman would have been awesome.
Still, this has to end. I can't just sit back and watch as you burn it all to the ground. It's up to me to stop you. And believe me, I will. I'm gonna set this right. The sins of the Yakuza are mine. And if I have to...
Yeah.
I'll take on every last one.
I changed my mind on that. I do... I can understand why Kiryu is here. Because he does feel guilt for his past. His choices as a Yakuza in the past. And like how he could have changed things. Like, the whole Ebina thing could have been avoided if... Right? Maybe it couldn't have been. No, it couldn't have been. But at least when Kiryu was chairman, he could have at least righted the ship, you know? He knows that he's shied away from that responsibility. He had other things he had to do, and maybe it was a mistake to do that, to shy away from the responsibilities of chairman. And so he's kind of seeing the pain that the Yakuza has caused, and this is him kind of just like dealing with that.
How very noble of you.
Come on, you forget what we said downstairs? You and the lone wolf routine, I swear.
Yeah, seriously. Now let's finish this together, huh?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Huh. Well then, let's begin. Kazuma Kiryu is about to make his final stand. And at the Millennium Tower, no less. What could be more fitting?
Oh shit. Wait, his back tattoo's sick.
Yeah.
It's a triclops.
I was thinking the same thing.
I mean, we all know how sick Kiryu's tattoo is.
Time to die.
Everyone's just ripped. It makes you feel so inadequate.
Come on. Demina!
Like, these guys are in their 50s. Well, Ebina's like 46 or 48 or something like that. But still, like, they're so ripped for that age. Like, what the fuck? I was never, ever that ripped in my life. I was strong, but I was never fucking ripped. Masataka Ebina. I love how...
Spout your ideals all you want, you're still Yakuza! That's all you'll ever be!
Can we, play Chance of Falling Guard?
I'm not backing down.
You think you can win? Who wants to go?
Okay, we're just gonna Essence of Remembrance him. What do we need? We need to lower his agility. Come on. Yes. Perfect. Ooh, he's resist fire. What is this? Oh, God. Line? That could be good. Lower defense. Chance to lower attack. We gotta lower his attack. Bam. Oh god. Okay, that was a lot. Fuck. Heal the squad.
Ready when you are.
Magic raise. Damn, his agility's down and he's still like this.
We doing it big?
Yeah.
Special order.
Enjoy.
And attack raise. That's some good damage, damn. Ooh. Asleep? Damn. Jewel Breaker. Okay. Not bad damage. She fell asleep too. Fuck.
Who wants to go?
Oh, you're weak to swords?
You think that was it? As if that was all it would take.
That's better.
Oh, her stone thingy's shattered. Okay, good. Holy shit, she died. She fucking died. That's fuck, that's crazy. Okay, Oh, I've gotta break his grapple.
Try this on your side. Gotta feel this one.
Follow my lead.
Holy shit, he's so strong. Okay, maybe a high chance of causing rage. I think I just need to have him rage out against me.
It's over.
Did he rage? He did not rage.
Are you done with all the fun and games?
Okay. Punch him. Hell yeah. Oh no, not a katana.
Let's settle this once and for all.
Okay. Is he no longer weak to... He's no longer weak to his blades, because now he has a blade. Well, actually, 1,000 isn't even that high, to be very fair. Do we have any... Doesn't cost a turn? Fuck yeah, let's... Aw, oh, man, we can't summon with... Doesn't cost a turn, man.
Delivery.
Hey, we need your help to fight this dude. Street fighting sensation. He's a real person. I still can't believe he's a real person. Urban hospitality. That's awesome.
Not bad at all.
You're no slouch.
Talk about bonds.
Here we go.
Taking responsibility. You disgust me.
I'm going you down.
We're just gonna wombo combo him. Okay, that was not bad, actually.
I'm over here. Are you done with all the fun and games yet?
Dual breaker. Can you wake up, please? Oh my god, you need to wake up.
What?
You're gonna be in a world of hurt.
Do we have any, like... Isn't he just gonna be asleep for the entire fight? That was a lot of damage. I won't lie. charge. That's 100,000. So I already did one summon? Is that why?
You're gonna be in a world of hurt.
Yeah, we'll remember it, Tim.
You. Kazuma Kiryu.
Can we, like, heal? Is there anything that, like, heals the team? Heals the squad? Where's my Tauriner? What about the party? Toughness Z. Yeah. That's pretty good. Thank you for waking up. Jesus Christ. Ooh, that is really good. We're just doing this to lower defense. Yes! That's huge. She's paralyzed now, are you kidding me? Those are my only grapple skills?
Yeah. Are you done with all the fun and games yet?
Time to put you down!
Ooh, Psycho, thank you. No, we just need to do damage. We're too far away from everyone. That's some good damage. Leave her alone! Stop it! Bop! Jewel Breaker. We could end him. We could end him by kicking him in the nuts? Oh, that's too big. We won by kicking him in the nuts! Oh my god, I can't believe we won by kicking him in the nuts. Hear you. Broke his sword by punching it. My dude. Wow. I like how Sunny was pretty much like incapacitated for that entire fight. Jesus Christ, but I can't believe you broke my soul stone. That's insane. That is insane.
That's enough now. Why don't we finish this?
Yeah.
Kiryu-san!
No, but don't even breathe heavy. You didn't even fight. Sawashiro.
He's incredible.
What's wrong? You're not gonna kill me?
Kiryu-san!
Kiryu never kills anyone except for the helicopter guy and the machine gunner.
This is your problem. It's why the Yakuza keep rearing their ugly heads. The lot of you. Whether you retire, whether you disband, you always come crawling back. You're a Yakuza through and through. And you can't erase that no matter what. You'll say sorry again and again, and then find some way to justify it. The bigger the Yakuza, the bigger and better the future they promise, all so they can keep on fighting. If you let me live, how long before I too come crawling back? You may have put things on hold for now, but someone can pick up the pieces, rid the world of your filth. If not me, then someone else. The country's elite demand it. They were counting on me to see it through. If you don't finish me off, the future stays the same. I'll still make an example of the Yakuza one way or another. If you truly want them all to break free and find their place in this world, then hurry up and put an end to this before it's too late! I've lived in the twilight of the Yakuza all my life! You get rid of me, or I will keep cutting back! Do you understand? Kazuma Kiryu!
We're not gonna kill you, dude.
Ebina. Nothing I say would ever be enough, and I've no right to try. The hate you have for Arakawa, for Hikawa, the crush you've carried, I get it. But please, I beg you, for their sake, give them the chance to atone. There's one way to do that. We all have to live on. Whether you're scum or not, that doesn't matter. You can't change a thing if you're dead. All of us, we have to keep going. And it's not light, nor is it dark. It's the grayest road there is. So please, Ebina. Please. You have to live.
This is so ridiculous.
You have to keep moving. I'm asking you. Please don't kill them.
There's two shortless dudes and
please.
Laying down, embracing each
I'll
other.
I apologize.
Bloodied.
I know it won't make up for any of this.
Crying.
But I'm sorry. Forgive me. No!
Oh shit, did he die?
Kiryu-san!
Stay with us, Kiryu-san!
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 Open your damn eyes, Kiryu!
Kiryu-san!
Don't die! You can't die! Kiryu!
Oh my god. He might. I mean, if he did die there, those are, like, really impactful words. I don't think he died. There's no way. What are they doing?
Watch out, man! Hey! What the hell's your problem? Dude! Hey, what?
Get the fuck away.
This guy? Huh? Hey, get all that?
We went inside.
Oh, fuck, AG.
Damn it.
Yo. Long time no see, Eichan.
Kasuga.
Now, the public wants what it wants, I guess. And right now, it looks like that's you. Funny how the tables turn sometimes, huh?
How'd you find me?
What? You haven't looked outside yet? Quite an audience brewing down there. Still, they don't know you're in here. They might have got the building right, but that's about it. Me? I got a little help from the police. Didn't take too long to find you after that.
I don't know if that's legal.
It's not just them, you know. It's everyone. Every Yakuza in the country wants your head on a plate. Abina's master plan. Anyone who's anyone knows you were a part of that.
Just tell me what you want, damn it!
Turn yourself in, Eichan. I'll even come with you.
Huh?
You can run, but I guarantee you won't last. They'll kill you, eventually. Even more than that. I want you to have a chance to atone. If you can see that through, well, let's head back to Hawaii, all right?
You... Why are you still acting like we're friends?
Because we are, man. I mean it, Eichan. After all said and done, you're still my pal. And you know, I'd be pretty stoked to know you feel the same way. Honest, I would.
How can you even think that? After everything I've done to you.
I guess I just can't help it. We spent all that time in Hawaii together. I mean, great food, plenty of bullshitting. Just a heck of a good time, really. Yeah, the truth kinda killed the mood. And you were a real pain in the ass, but I could never forget what fun we did have. No way.
He's too pure, man.
Eichan, you can't take those things back. And running away isn't gonna help either. Even if you do serve your sentence, those choices will still be there. But you always have a chance to start over. Accept what you did. Be real with yourself. Only then can you take that first big step forward. If you really want to start your life over, guess what, man? You can.
Kasuga.
I'm telling you, Eichan. If you really feel like you want to give it a fresh start, then we'll do it together. I promise. I'll be right there waiting. The day you get out, whether it's years or even decades, I'll be there.
You can't be serious. No one would ever believe that. And yet, somehow, I know you're telling the truth. It's who you are. Who you've always been. You're as rare as they come. To think I get to meet you.
Yeah, well, you say rare, others say foolish.
Foolish, huh? The only foolish one here is me. So give it to me straight. Can I really go to the police like this? Seriously, I don't even have ID.
Yeah, you'll be all right. I'm used to this part too. Just leave it to me.
Appreciate the help.
You're hurt, huh?
I got chased on my way here, among other things. pretending finally caught up to me, huh? On goes, I suppose.
Hey, the fact you think that's a good thing means you'll be just fine.
What?
If you didn't think that, then who knows how you'd feel. Better to feel bad, right? That means you can make amends, without a doubt. Here, grab my shoulder.
That we cannot be seen. Is infinite wealth the friends we made along the way? Jesus Christ. This game hates fucking influencers. He's gonna throw that fucking can. Well, it's an empty can, right? Looks empty. Throw trash at them. Cup ramen. He doesn't even care. Ichiban's a fucking man. Never forget that Ichiban is actually the man. Oh, they're not gonna go. They're just gonna... Oh, don't throw a fucking bottle.
Asuka-san, please. It's all my fault. I'm sorry.
No, man. I'm used to this kind of thing. Besides, if they want to hate, I say let them. The hell should either of us care? We know where you're at. Your heart's in the right place. That's all that matters. That said, if you ever feel down, or even a little lost, by all means, give me a ring. Hear you out. I mean, what are friends for, right?
He's the best boy. God, hear you. Those fucking losers. Are you gonna get in my way again? He's not gonna punch him, is he? AG's pissed. Fucking Kosuga is crazy, man. I fucking love him. Jesus Christ. Ichiban was just casually assaulted.
I think that's good. Thanks. Sure thing.
Well, then, I guess it's goodbye for now.
For now. Thank you for everything, Kasuga-san.
Yeah. See you around, Eichan.
Yeah. Till then.
Hey, John! Ohuiho, pal! Ohuiho!
Ohuiho.
Do you even know what you're saying? Right.
Ohuiho! Ichiban! Hell yeah!
Hell yeah, brother.
Hang in there, Eichan. All right. It's time for some grub.
What are you gonna eat? Smile Burger. Was that like a Jack Daniels bottle? Jesus Christ. Okay, who did that? Fucking loser. That's the end. What? No. What? Danny Trejo. The man, Danny Trejo. Okay, that was... Whoa. What the fuck? I gotta love Matt Mercer. David Hayter. Wait, David Hayter's the bartender? He's the guy who plays Solid Snake. Or voices Solid Snake. I didn't realize... I mean, yeah, I can hear it now a little bit, but... Oh, shit. That... I can't, that can't be, there has to be a scene after this. There has to be a scene after this. But I'm gonna give my impressions. I'm gonna give this game an A. A, absolutely A. At the bare minimum, it deserves an A. Bare minimum, it deserves an A minus, I'll say. Special appearances by Gachapin and Muku. Is Gachapin and Muku real things? The news women, Kason. Gachapin. oh my god, Gachapin is a real thing and he shows up on a children's TV show. Is Muku also in that show? Could you imagine? So, this is the equivalent of playing a game, and then all of a sudden, you see fucking Big Bird on an island, and he's saying, make this a resort island. Oh my god, Gachapin and Muku. That's fucking crazy. Dude, Ryusuke Horii made a fucking great game. I think this is incredible. I think this is actually might be one of the best Like a Dragon games I've played. I thought 7 was amazing. And I think, honestly, I might like the story of 7 just a tiny bit more. But I think the gameplay elements of 8 that have innovated on 7 are just insane. I feel like the pound system became more useful here. I feel like I did use more of that than before. I can see why people would use that more. I also... I also just like just the general base attacks. Like in a lot of RPGs, it feels like you're wasting time, especially in this type of game. You feel like you're wasting time when you're using a basic attack. I don't feel like that anymore. The addition, and maybe it's not addition, I don't know exactly what has been added, but combo attacks and back attacks and attacking when they're down and proximity attacks, all of these different types of attacks. Like, maybe 7 had some of these, but the addition of all of these made that the simple basic attack felt very strong. I did like all of the different types of attack skills that you got during the game. I don't know, I just felt like the gear, everything about the combat system felt way better. I was very impressed by that. Let's see, let me turn this down a little bit. What else was there? Yeah, no, I think combat-wise, this is like an A+. Like, absolutely. The only thing I wish they could have done a little bit more is that I just wish the job system was more integrated. Like here's what I wish. I wish you could have a main class and a subclass. Like a main job and sub job, and both get leveled up when you had them in. Or only one gets leveled up. I didn't want to just carry over the skills, because you also, like, you know, obviously you carry over to your, like, attack skills and whatnot, but then you lose all of the traits, like the additional, like, buffs, like a plus attack, plus HP, that you got from, like, your main guy, or your main job. So it kind of, like, didn't behoove you to switch jobs, even though in the end of the day it would be better, because you get to carry, and that's actually another thing, it's great that you get to carry over those, some of those pluses, but I just didn't want to do it. Yeah. So, I think there could have been some work, and I hope for Yakuza 9, they do try and work on that, fix that up just a little bit more. But yeah, I mean, yeah, I don't know. I think that was strong. I'm going to avoid talking about story for now, because I feel like there's going to be one part at the end that's really going to add to the story. I think there's one more scene, and I don't want to comment if I haven't seen the last fucking scene. You know what I mean? Tattoo design, Horitomo. So they have like an on-staff like tattoo designer for all the people who have tattoos. That's fucking sick. I think side content is actually insane in this game. So first off, they have Pokemon, and not only did they just have Pokemon, it's actually like pretty well developed Pokemon. Like, I know it was like kind of like shitting on it. I think they could have like done a little bit more work to make it more like, I wish I could just kind of could have brute forced it a little bit more, but I like the 3v3 kind of like setting of like, oh, what matters, who's in your lineup, there's Pokemon that are faster and it'll make you attack more, but they're going to be weaker in general. And also with hype advantage and switching out and everything like that. Like, it was a very, it's a very smart game, I will say. I was surprised for a side game that how in-depth it was. I kind of quit after a while, but I've got to say, it was actually pretty interesting. And then, obviously, we have the fucking roguelike dungeon. Not roguelike, but like the procedurally generated dungeon, which, cool. It was good. I'm glad that they had that. It's a good place to level up. But first and foremost, the fact that they added Animal Crossing to the game was fucking insane. Like, Animal Crossing, are you kidding me? I am shocked. It's so funny because you can tell, like, all of the different assets, all the different items and floors and everything, you can tell that they just pulled that from all of the different games, from Yakuza, like, Kiwami, like, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like a Dragon, Zero. You can tell because some of it actually looks a little bit more pixelated and a little bit worse. They just took all of the assets they've ever made for all previous games and they're like, hey, you can use this here. So I'm really impressed by what they were able to do with that. I did think it went on a little bit too long. But I think it was pretty cool. I think they could have done things here and there to make it a little bit better, but honestly, at the end of the day, they fucking crushed it. That's a lot of content to put in the game. That's not even the game's main content. And just the little games that they have here and there, like the Pokemon Snap. They really liked Pokemon, I guess. The Crazy People Snap, whatever you want to call it. They had Crazy Taxi, but like Crazy Eats. Apparently they're making a new Crazy Taxi game. And I've heard it's like a live service, like was it Battle Royale? I don't know. Something like that. It's supposed to be like AAA, and I'm just like, that's not what I want from a Crazy Taxi game. I just want to play like a low-budget single-player game, and all I want to hear is, hey, you look cool, get in. You know what I mean? Theme song. Sheena Ringo. The Invaluable. Of course, because we have infinite wealth. Still funny that they never explained, they never said infinite. I mean, that just feels so weird if they were to say the name of the game. But I know so many do it, but like it doesn't really feel like they touched upon it as much as it could have. Like that infinite wealth is like the friends and like the bonds that you make. It really didn't feel like it touched too much on it, but I don't really think it had to. Oh, I think we're back to story. God, okay.
Hard to believe it's been a month.
Time
sure flies, huh?
Ebina, AG, Bryce, they've all but vanished. Guess people have moved on.
Yeah? So what's
true? They mean online.
Some two-timing politician who got caught in the act?
Yeah, figures as much.
Well, just the way of the world, man. The public eye came through for us, at least. Who are we to complain?
Let alone care. Life will go on either way. As long as we remember that, that's all that matters.
Okay, what about this? Ebina's angle. Why keep Sawashiro alive that whole time?
Right.
He hated the Yakuza for all they're worth.
That is true.
What do you mean, why? He said so himself, right? That bit about his own aspirations being forfeit from the get-go.
Yeah?
That's true.
Well, the dude still had a role to play. From what I gathered, he was probably hoping someone would speak up to him before things got out of hand. Tell him, yeah, I get that you're angry, or hey, it's gonna be all right. I'm sure that would have made all the difference. I mean, you're looking at a guy who had people telling him who and what he was from day one. Crazy as it sounds, the two of us might as well have shared shoes. How I need to live is one thing. How I want to live is another. Get those mixed up, then life don't make a whole lot of sense.
Or maybe it's just that Sawashiro was a lot tougher than he thought.
Yeah, what was I thinking?
Well, Ebina had his reasons. Guess that one will stay with him. Besides, it's not like all's said and done. Lonnie's got a lot of responsibility coming her way.
To think of a little girl like her's their new sage. Almost seems cruel, don't it?
Look, Lonnie made that decision herself. She had good reason to. Rebuilding the group will help her keep that orphanage going.
That's true. Plus, Akane-san's with her, too. As a matter of fact, I'm planning to help out once I'm back stateside.
Oh, that's good.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Their soup kitchen saved my ass loads of times. It's the least I can do to say thanks. Bryce aside, Policana still did plenty of good for others.
I don't know if we're going to see Tomizawa again. We're definitely going back to Hawaii. They already made the asset for Hawaii. We're definitely going to... I think the next game's going to primarily take place in Japan. I think they're going to stay back in Japan, but I think there'll probably be like a side chapter or two of like going to Hawaii, and like we'll probably run into Tomizawa, but I don't know if he's going to continue to be a party member. I really don't. And I don't like Tomizawa, don't get me wrong, but I just feel like this is kind of explaining like, hey, what's he going to do when he's not in the next game? I don't know, but like it feels like such a waste to like make the entire, like as you saw with Kamurocho, they love using the city of Kamurocho again and again and again because they made all the assets for it. And same with the Jincho. Like, we spent a lot of time there. They spent all this time making, like, Honolulu, and they're not going to come back to it? No. We're coming back to it. But it's just, it's harder of an ask in the story to explain why we're going back to Honolulu. You know what I mean? Like, you can easily explain you're going to Kamurocho to Ijincho because you're in the same country, you know? Probably not too far away by bullet. How far... Actually, you know what? I can look this up. How far is Kamurocho to Ijincho? And Sotenbori. Oh, yeah, and Sotenbori. So Kamurocho to Sotenbori takes, by car, 6.5 hours, and by train, 3 hours and 47 minutes. So that's interesting. Interesting. Okay. But yeah, we're probably going to come back to Hawaii, but I just don't know how much Tomizawa will be involved.
He's homeless, need help too.
Maybe we come back to see Tomizawa.
Now's the time to step up. You know, lend others a hand.
Over to see his mom.
I'll be darned. You've really grown up.
Come on, man. I'm just trying to do what I can. I mean, I'm
that beer looks good.
Compared to Lonnie, even less so Chitose.
That's right. She's chosen a difficult road for herself.
Oh, she's going to lead the Fujinomiya.
Not only did she expose their misdeeds, but she became the Fujinomiya chairwoman.
Oh, yeah.
She wasn't too keen on her family, either.
Right.
You know, I think I kind of get how she feels. When you're around Ichiban, there's this feeling like you gotta do your best, no matter what. And it's natural. It's not like he's barking orders at you left and right.
No, I get what you mean. It was the same for all of us, too.
Sure was.
That's just the kind of man he is, through and through.
So... you guys think old Kasuga-kun might actually set things straight this time around?
Huh? Oh, yeah. He's still hemming and hawing out there?
Oh my god, of course.
Get warm at this rate.
Ichiban, seriously.
Before we go into this, so they did explain the game... The last scene of the game wants to explain, okay, Tomizawa is going to be doing this in Hawaii. Chitose is going to be doing this in Japan. I think they're trying to say, hey, you might not see these party members all the time in future games. I think the core crew is what we have, and, like, you know, the Yakuza 7 crew is what we have. You might see Chitose, and you might see Tomizawa, but they have other responsibilities. They have other things that they're doing.
Can I go back inside?
Sorry, Sachan.
Which is good, because the party is, like, getting so fucking big. Like, we need to have the party split up because of that.
Quit dicking around!
Oh my god.
Or shut up, Ichiban Kasuga!
Right. Okay.
Center yourself.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Sachan. You see, there's something I want to say. Sachan, well, since last year, all I thought about is you, ever since our date that day. For all I said, I didn't once consider your feelings. As if my selfish ramblings were the problem, and that was the only thing I'd done wrong. And it's not like those weren't stupid things to say, but I finally get it now. That wasn't really the issue. In fact, there was something I should have told you right off the bat. That was something I missed, and it was dumb of me not to see it sooner. It took me a year, but I finally figured out what it was. So with that, Sachan, it's time I say it. I want you to hear how I feel. Sachan.
I love how they're just doing this outside the bar.
I love you. I'm in love with you.
Finally! Finally, you say it! Oh, I swear, it took you long enough.
Yeah. Well, sorry about that.
No, I should say sorry, too. I totally ignored you.
Cool. Guess we're even?
Yeah, we're even.
You're not gonna say it back? He fucking, like, says something like that to her, and she's just like,
I really did keep
Thanks for
waiting.
Saying. Thank you.
But hey, this time, I, Ichiban Kasuga, promise to make it up to you. Actually, I've been saving a little something special for today.
What?
Don't freak out, all right? Ta-da!
No.
So, what do you think? I figured just saying it wouldn't cut it. I really wanted to put it out there. Hey, guess what? I even got one for you, too. We can wear them together. Show them off all over Yokohama. I mean, what better way to start our journey? Saigo, son?
Well, he tried.
He didn't run that through the party, did he?
True. You know, dumbasses like that rarely give up.
I mean, to be fair, the last time he got advice from the party, it didn't really go that well.
They'll tough it out, no matter the odds.
She's so fucking pissed.
Hey, wait! Hang on a second!
Okay, thank you. As much as I love the Looney Tunes, I need to know what's going on with Kiryu. Oh my god, that's Haruto. Holy shit. Haruka and Haruto.
Hey, Mom. How come Grandpa isn't here?
That's like Kiryu's
okay,
daughter,
Haruto.
Man.
It's okay, Haruto.
Oh, fuck.
If I know him, we'll see him soon. I know we will.
The Leniac Room. What the fuck does that mean?
Hello.
Okay.
You're the inpatient with the 11 a.m. this morning, is that correct? If you would, could you please provide your full name, sir?
It's Kiryu. Kazuma Kiryu.
His name. Goddamn. Well, the man who regained his name. Oh my, that's the achievement that popped up. Oh my god, dude. Premium Adventure. You can now play Premium Adventure. Load a completed save file to continue exploring locales like Honolulu and Ancient Show while retaining all the abilities and items you've acquired over your journey. We wish you luck in completing any unfinished challenges. Congratulations on completing the game's story. You will receive this following rewards: Special Outfit Love Psycho Shirt, Special Outfit Resurrected Dragon, Tsujimon Kazuma Kiryu Resurrected Dragon. Shit. So that's his, like, the gray outfit was the Resurrected Dragon outfit. So is there some main menu gonna look any different? No. Okay. Well, let me exit the game so I can talk a little bit more. Oh man. Okay. Well, I'm glad those last two scenes occurred. Because obviously the game, there was a lot of focus in this game about Ichiban and Psycho, and there was a lot of focus in this game about Kiryu and his past and Haruto and Haruko, or Haruka, Haruta, I think it's Haruta, yeah. So that did, like, add a little bit of a cherry to things. Before I get to the main story, I'm going to start talking about some of the side story. So first I want to talk about the side quest kind of stuff, like, outside of just, like, the big stuff, the side stories. I thought they were good. Again, I feel that everything is a bit too much. No, and here's the thing. I have, like, a completionist mindset. Like, I want to do everything. But it kind of, like, causes the feel of the game to be thrown off. Like, I'm doing all these side missions, and then, like, I'm just, like, putting off the main quest, which feels like it's urgent. And I don't like that. And, like, going one by one by one to all of them, it just feels, like, nonsensical. You know what I mean? I did like a lot of them, though. I did like the guy that, like, would with the hula dancer girl, and I liked that story. I liked Mike's Lemonade, even though I didn't finish that one. I think it was Mike's Lemonade. I don't know. I liked me as a waiter. That was fun. The movie shit, like jumping away from, like, fucking cars and shit, like, or running away from cars, all that stuff. That, like, they were really good, but I feel like what they need to do, and I think if it would be better if I could accept the fact that I won't complete them all, and I just do them organically as I come across, and, like, you know, so no two game, like, you know, playthroughs will be alike. They'll all have, like, different ones that were completed. However, my preference would be that they at least half the amount of side quests, and expand on those side quests. Like, put it a little bit more, like work on those side quests. Make them, I don't know, more interesting, more, like, fulfilling, more, like, you just put more, like, manpower into it to really build them up. I think that would be a lot better. I really do. And when it comes to drink links, I really do enjoy the drink links. I think the stories for them were all generally good. I've got no bad comments about them. For Kiryu's side of things, I think his side quest seemed fine. Like, there wasn't too many crazy stuff. A lot of his, actually, his side, specific side quests were just like, hey, you're gonna talk to this person for a little bit. Maybe they had something to do with Kiryu's past. Maybe they don't even have anything to do with his past, but, like, they kind of talk about, you know, getting older, your past, your, like, you know, talking in general, or, like, or their own issues kind of relate to Kiryu's in some way. I think that's been, those were interesting. I think his remembrances were pretty interesting for the most part, and probably would have been something I focused on more if it wasn't for the fact that I just didn't play majority of the Yakuza games. So they didn't really hit. I knew of some of those things that he was talking about, but it just didn't hit with me because I was just like, oh, well, yeah, I don't remember that. And then the drink links, again, that's another thing that would have hit more if I played all the games. Like, I stopped doing them because I was like, well, I don't actually know any of these characters. Like, I don't remember them at all. The only one that I kind of remembered was the kid at, like, the hostess club. Or not kid, but, like, you know, he was one of the orphans that Kiryu took care of in 3. And I remember him. And it's so funny that 3 is such a, 3 is such an important game to this, because 3 is where he runs, because, like, I didn't really play 1 or 2, but, like, 1 or 2 has nothing to do with, like, the orphanage. Like, yes, Kiryu is known for, like, growing up in an orphanage, but it's more of just him taking care of, like, Haruta, whatever. He's taking care of, like, the little girl. And then in 3, he kind of escapes Tojo shit and lives in Okinawa for a while, running an orphanage. And along with Haruka, he's taking care of, like, all these other orphans, including that kid. But, like, it really expands on, like, how important orphanages are for him, because, like, you know, he grew up in an orphanage and he met, like, his, like, role model in an orphanage. So it's crazy how important, like, 3 was, even though 3 is by far considered the worst game of all of the Yakuza mainline games. So that's interesting. But yeah, I just didn't really feel connected to it in any way, so I just stopped doing it. So that's my thoughts when it comes to, like, side stuff. But when it comes to the main story, so the main story is very interesting. I am so glad that they went to Hawaii. I thought Hawaii was such a breath of fresh air. Having Kasuga and team deal with Americans, like, I'll sue you. Seeing the Yakuza team's, like, ideas of how to make American NPCs is so fucking funny to me. It's so fucking funny. I really did enjoy that. What else? Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to think of all the stuff that I want to talk about before I talk about the story. But I think that's good. I think now all I want to say about the story is I think it's good. I don't know if it beat 7. I don't think it beat 7. I think 7's story was the best. I think the rising up story of Kasuga, you know, in jail, getting out of jail, basically having, like, the worst fucking luck ever. I think just seeing the insane bad luck from Kasuga was crazy in 7. Like, him, like, going to jail for something he didn't do for, like almost 20 years, right? And then coming out, meeting up with his, like, you know, like, the his like, role model dad kind of thing. His role, finding out that his family has, like, switched sides to the Omi Alliance, and his dad shooting him and leaving him for dead. goes and lives in, like, you know, he, like, recovers in a homeless encampment. He just had such bad fucking luck, and he was always, like, such a positive dude the entire thing. I think the entire story for the, like, Yakuza Like a Dragon was amazing. Just actually incredible. For Infinite Wealth, I think it's pretty good. I do think it's pretty good. I'm glad that there's, like, more of, like, a romance with, like, Psycho. Just that last scene was so fucking stupid. Oh my god. I just wanted him to, like, have a win, you know? But the fact that he just fucked it up right at the end is just so fucking stupid. Oh my god. But yeah, you know, I think it's funny how much this game hates VTubers and hates social media people. Really had a lot to say about that, which is funny. I did like I said, I liked Hawaii. I liked the gangs in Hawaii. I liked the Barracudas. I liked Danny Trejo. I thought they were interesting. Polycana, I don't know if I liked Polycana. It just felt so over the top stupid. Like, I can accept gangs and shit like that, but I'm like, oh, like, this white dude came in, supplanted, like, you know, leadership, and this whole, like, thing of, like, oh, we're gonna, like, put radioactive waste on this island, and we're gonna make some money, and, you know, we're gonna, our leadership, and, like, you know, like, we're gonna get, like, political influence around the world, all of that shit. I'm like, this is so fucking, like, over the top dumb. But I went along with it. I can go along with a dumb ride. But yeah, you know, some of it felt like a little bit like filler. But it wasn't too bad. I liked having Kasuga and Kiryu work together as a team for the first few chapters, and then them split up and split the party. I think, honestly, having two protagonists in two different locations was amazing, and I hope they do that again. I actually thought, I wasn't sure I was going to like it, because I was like, oh man, like, I'm going to want to know what happens next in one person's story, and then whenever the chapter ends, I'm going to want to feel like I want to stay with that. No, I actually, if anything, it kept me, like, having renewed interest the entire way through. Like, sometimes it does feel like a slog, but I feel like it took a lot longer for it to start to feel like a slog in this game. Because when I would leave a chapter, yes, I'd be interested in seeing what happened for, like, the other team, but also I just wanted to get back to the next chapter, so, like, I was, I don't know, like, doubly interested in a way. But yeah. What else? Yeah, I don't know. I don't really know. Yeah, the whole second dissolution. Would you? I mean, I guess they really did do. They did do the second dissolution. They did do that. I was gonna say, like, wait, did they not do it? But yeah, they did, and they were supposed to, like, basically become Bleach Japan and send everyone. So what happens to all the Yakuza? Like, we didn't even find out what's gonna happen with everyone. Everyone's still, like, all those ex-Yakuza are still dealing with the 5-year clause, and they're kind of still fucked. I didn't really go to... I love how, like, the beginning of the game was just, like, Ichiban trying to find a way to see the boss's will be completed. And then, obviously, he got cancelled, so he could no longer complete the boss's will. And what Ebina and Bryce were doing was basically making it the opposite, where he was basically screwing... They were trying to screw everyone over who was ex-Yakuza. But we never actually saw what happens, like, next. Like, how are they going to still try to help the former Yakuza members? So I'm guessing that's probably going to be part of the third game in this series. But it is kind of funny that they just did not touch on that at all. I don't know, but I'd say the story was good. I'll say it's good. where things end up, you know, like I said during like that ending scene, I do think that like Tomizawa and Chitose maybe won't be coming back for future games. I think they're just kind of like, they were this game's like, hey, we're like guest party members, but they basically said, we have other things to do. Tomizawa has to work in like the Polykana. Chitose has to be a Fujinomiya chairwoman. They basically said, hey, just to let you guys know, these characters might be busy in the next game. We might see them for a bit, but you probably aren't going to spend extensive amounts of time with them. Which is fine. And I would love for both of them to make an appearance in the next game, but I'm okay with them not being in the next game. I'm okay with Tomizawa not being, but Chitose was actually kind of cool. Like, I did enjoy Chitose, like, a lot. I thought Kiryu was gonna die. I'm a little surprised Kiryu didn't die. It just felt like this game was wrapping up every single loose end in Kiryu's story. That it just felt like, okay, they want to say this is the final time Kiryu will be around. But even still, now he's like the man who regained his name. So I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do with Kiryu's character going forward. I hope they don't use him. I want the interaction with Haruka, Haruto, and Kiryu. And I want them to, like, okay. I would be okay with that. If in the next game, those three meet up, they have a reunion, and they decide to go somewhere, and Kiryu's out of the picture. I do want Kiryu to have a happy ending, but I don't think he should keep going like this. Even if he regained his name, he needs a break. I don't know what the future is for Ichiban, though. Like, I mean, obviously, it's so, again, it's so funny that they didn't touch upon the fact that, like, what are they going to do with the Yakuza? Like, at the end of the last game, you knew, like, okay, like, Ichiban did all this shit, was able to, like, you know, save the day, but, like, he still, like, you knew what he wanted to do. He wanted to help people. But in this, I mean, like, I'm guessing he's going to try and go back to helping Yakuza. They haven't figured it out yet. Like, it was literally like only a month after the end of the last game, but my guess is the beginning of the next game will show us what happened with Ichiban, and like what he's been doing to help things out. But I'm guessing we're not gonna get that for a couple of years now, unfortunately. So I mean, by the time the next game comes out, I mean, hope maybe it'll come out sooner, who knows, but it'll probably be a few years at the very least by the time the next game comes out. And they'll probably explain what he's been doing and how he's been trying to make the boss's dream occur. But yeah, I will absolutely play the next game. Like, I really, really want to. I hope. These games are crazy long, but I really hope I have the bandwidth to play the next game. But we'll see when that comes out. Until then, my friends. Well, one last sneeze for the road, I guess. I hope you enjoyed this game. I certainly did. Even though I had my like reservations about some parts of the story and like, you know, side content and everything, I still think it was a phenomenal game, and I enjoyed it a lot. Definitely gets a thumbs up from me. So I'll see you next time for the next game.